Alright everyone, welcome back to Drill Man's Land. I hope you're having an amazing day. Today we're going to be taking a break from all those 50mm and 55mm lenses and taking a step in a more lengthy direction. And by lengthy, I mean telephoto. Today I've got a special lens. It's in this container. Let's get into what it is. Today we're going to be talking about the Hoya 70-210mm F3.8. Yes, you heard me right. That is a 3.8 to F22 telephoto SLR lens designed for the FD mount, meaning it was designed for Canon film SLR cameras about 30 years ago. And I know what you're thinking, this guy's hashtag Nikon Nation, why does he keep strapping old Canon glass onto his Nikon Z camera? I don't know, it just is what it is. So first of all, let's have a quick look at the adapter. It is the KNF Concept Nikon Z to FD mount. One thing to keep in mind about these mounts is they're very well built, but sometimes this joint can get a little bit loose. So there's some screws in there. Make sure that you tighten it before using it, especially with a heavy lens like this. And one other cool thing I am going to be doing tonight with my Nikon Z camera is putting in the focal length onto the custom lens feature. If you saw my last video, check above my left hand here, I went through how to actually get to that feature. And being this is a zoom lens, we're just going to set it for 210mm just to be safe. And by doing this, I'm actually able to use the IBIS that's in the camera with this ancient lens, which will be key for doing run and gun street photography, because usually with telephoto, you want to use a tripod, but we don't have time for that on Joe Man's Land. All right, let's get to Calgary.
Hoya Corporation was founded in the city of Hoya, Tokyo in 1941 by Shochochi and Shigeru Yamanaka, two visionary brothers. Originally a small manufacturer of optical lenses, the company saw opportunities in the emerging fields of healthcare and information technology. In 1958, Hoya ventured into the eyeglass business and the manufacturing of lenses for press materials. Seeing as I have this microphone, perhaps it is worth doing an overdub as the illustrious David Attenborough. And now it is time for the magical photographer to go into his natural habitat. Walking in around the city with a giant 10-pound telephoto lens, this strange being is not at all disguised. Clearly visible to his natural predators, the photographer must walk quickly, not using a tripod and always getting very shaky footage.
This is really good lighting. Well, it's not really, it's just lighting. All right, we are done with this part of downtown. Let's go wrap it up at one last parkade and maybe we can get a long exposure along the way.
Oh look, he's found some people walking away from him. He now feels safe to take a photo of these people.
All right, so now we're rocking at 70mm. I'm probably about 15, 20 feet away from the camera now, so definitely a lot closer. So right now you're seeing me through 110. Let's punch that into 200. This is punched in at 210. It's probably totally out of focus. It's pretty hard to focus the lens that far away. Some reasons you might want to use a telephoto for talking head stuff is if you want a lot of compression between the background and you, which can be super duper cool. It might seem a little bit lazy shooting my outro in the same place I did the demo shots with the manual lens, but it's such a beautiful view and you couldn't really get a feel for that with the focal range this lens had, so I thought I would just wrap it up here. I picked this lens up for $30 in Winnipeg, and for something that was mint condition, came in the original container, had no blemishes, that was a really good deal. This lens is for someone that wants to dabble with telephoto, wants some different types of bokeh, and wants an all-around zoom lens that they can just walk around with. It's well made and made out of solid metal, so it is heavy. So be prepared to get a sore neck if you're using a camera strap. What I did, which you might have noticed, was I wrapped a strap around the outside of my jacket. By doing that, I'm able to stop it from rubbing against my neck and causing a rash. Please tell me in the comments below if you've had any experience using a Hoya. There's not a ton of information about this lens manufacturer online. So what I shared with you in the overdub was what I know, but maybe you know more. So comment below if you know more about this awesome, awesome lens. Hit that like button, subscribe to the channel. Remember to take beautiful photos every single day. Don't do it for the views, do it for yourself. We will see you in the next one.